Hello, it's Wednesday, so it must be time for Woolly Hat's Wednesday Whip. Well, the sun's shining, as you can see. I'm having difficulty getting the sun right, so if I go in and out, then please excuse me. But the weather has warmed up. Still a bit chilly in the evening, so we need to wear our nice jumpers that we've knitted ourselves. But definitely warming up, and lots more birds in the garden. I think they were keeping warm in the bushes last week. Anyway, so what have I been doing knitting-wise and crochet-wise? Well, last week I showed you I was doing some crochet with some yarn I found in my stash. It's a cotton. I'm not quite sure what it is because I lost the label, which is a bad thing, but there we go. Always keep the label. But this was the idea, was it's a bag, which I've done, I've finished it, and then you have a little bag to put the bag in at the bottom. The only problem is I haven't made the bag big enough now, just to show you that I don't always get it right. So it sort of nearly goes in. There you go. So it needs to be a little bit bigger. Otherwise the thing is sort of like innards popping out. But it was quite a nice pattern, so I need to take this off and make it a bit bigger, which is annoying. But there we go. But it's a nice bag, great for doing your roses or even buying some yarn when we next back into the shops. So that's my little crochet project, using up some stash, which is good. And here's my finished crochet hook case, which I've been doing for the next steps for crochet. And so the idea of this is to practice learning stitches. So there's some trebles, doubles and half trebles in there. And then on the front, there's some spike stitch. Now when you do the spike stitch, it looks like that. But when you don't like that, it looks like that. So that's quite nice. I like spike stitch. It's a good way of decorating borders and things. And it's very useful for lots of other things. And this is done in double crochet, but you can also do it using half treble or treble as well. And I'll, in the next steps, I'll be showing you how that's done. So that was a bit of homework for me. And then my project, as you remember, I'm knitting Lily of the Valley cardigan, a rowan pattern by Marie Wallen for my friend for her birthday. And I've done the back and I've done the left front, and I'm going through the right front. As you can see, it's very fine. It's 4-ply cotton from Rowan. And because it's shaped with the rib at the bottom, there's 44 rows of rib there in teeny tiny needles, 2.25. So that was, it didn't take as long as I thought it would, but there we go. So yes, it's all, the stocking stitch is very easy. So I've been doing that, I'm really enjoying that. So now I'm doing the left front. No, I'm doing the right front. Once I've done that, I have to decide whether I'm going to go straight to the arms or whether I'm going to sew up the front and the back and then put the border on, but I'll have to see. So you can follow me and look at tips for making garments on the Woolly Hat client group on Facebook. The latest video is about casting on and ribs and what's most appropriate for your garments and little tips and things. So please do go over there and have a look. And if you've got any questions, please ask. That'll be fab. So in between actually doing knitting crochet, I have had through the letterbox a couple of magazines. I get a couple just because I do. I do read some online, but I like to have ones that you can look at. And after much research, I've decided these are ones I subscribe to. Inside Crochet has a range of patterns. But something that caught my eye this time was, it's very cute, little cardigan for a little girl. So lots of little boys in our family, but not so many little girls. So I'm going to have to find a little girl to knit this. It's using a granny square treble cluster. So if you know how to do a granny square, you should be able to do this. So this might be a nice project to do if you've not done a garment, just to try out the things. It seems a fairly simple pattern. It's a little bit of shaping for the arms, but not a lot. And then the only other difficult bit might be the border around the edge. But that's a nice pattern to start. If you've not done any garments using crochet, that's quite a nice pattern to start off with. So also in the knitter, which sometimes have some very weird patterns in, but this one, just had it all lined up for you and then it's got discombobulated. So here we go. So I opened this double page spread up and thought, oh, that looks rather nice. And I was talking about the pattern. It's a Lisa Richardson pattern, and she does a lot of work for Rowan at the moment, but and I've knitted a few of her designs before. She likes using a lot of colour, but she also likes doing cable. And this one is knitted in Rowan Soft Yak, and I used the Soft Yak last year to do a crochet top in broomstick crochet, and that was very nice. It felt a bit like a very soft cotton. Doesn't have as much elasticity as wool. I asked Mr. W if he would like a jumper like that, and he said, no, I've got enough jumpers, which of course was the wrong answer. Doesn't usually do the wrong answer, but he did on this occasion. Anyway, I have many projects on the go now, so I haven't really got time to do that. And I did knit him a jumper before Christmas or last summer. So that's that. Now, the other thing is, this afternoon I'm going to go for my vaccination, for my jab. I didn't realise I was so old, but obviously I am. So that's very exciting. So when you see me next time, I shall be jabbed and vaccinated and whatever. So hopefully I'll be all right. I'm sure I will be. So that's it for this week. I hope you have some good news as well, and that you're knitting and crocheting and watching the birds or going for nice walks. And one day we'll all be able to see each other and do a bit of communal knitting and a few classes, and that will be wonderful, won't it? So keep your pecker up, as they say, and I will see you next week. That's all for now. Bye-bye.